I carried a loaded Beretta with me into the audition just to feel the weight of it.
Did you get the part?
Oh, they freaked out. Love that show. I love these guys. Henry Winkler starring alongside Bill Hader in the hit HBO series Barry, about an assassin turned wannabe actor. And Henry is in Chicago today for the launch of his new book called Alien Superstar, about an alien who crash lands on Earth and is accidentally cast in a TV show. The nicest guy in show business joining us this morning.
Great,
Henry, welcome back.
Good morning. Good morning. So nice to be here again.
I got to tell you, that show, Barry, it just lures you in. Yes. The writing is so good. And I'm wondering, was Bill Hader a fan of yours from way back? That, how did you guys hook up for that show? The role is brilliant.
I was leaving an estate planning meeting. We were driving down Ventura Boulevard in the Valley, in California, and I got a call. Bill Hader, HBO, you're on a short list. I said, okay, who else is on that short list? Is Dustin Hoffman on that short list? Because if Dustin Hoffman is on that list, I can't go in because he's going to get it. And they said, no, they're really interested in you, but I auditioned.
Yeah.
My son Max directed me in the audition.
Yeah.
I went in, then he calls me up, Bill Hader calls me up and says, will you come in again and just play? And I'm thinking, no, I don't want to do that, because if you're calling me a second time, let's leave the first one as the best one.
Yeah.
And Max did it again, my son, and I got the part, and here we are. We're going to start the third season, shooting it in March.
And you were nominated for Emmys three times during Happy Days. This is the first win,
yes,
right? What an honor that had to be.
It was amazing. But you know what? Here it is. I'm very used to having not call my name. My tush never leaving the seat. But the Emmy really is that I'm still in this great show, Barry, and that I'm not dead yet. They have kept me alive.
Good, yeah. Yeah, they haven't killed you off at all.
No.
Is it significantly different when you're making something like this or some of the comedies that you've made, Happy Days, but also movies? Is this different? Does it feel different to you as an actor?
It feels different because I am more mature as an actor. You know, I'm more mature as a human being. But everything begins and ends with the writing.
Yeah.
The writing is the answer. If it's not on the page, it's not on the stage.
Right.
And the two men, Alec Berg and Bill Hader, are so precise in their writing, so clear in what they want the show to be. Then they hire four or five other writers. They sit in a room together and plan out the eight episodes.
Yeah. I'm surprised because in Happy Days you played the Fonz, but I always loved your role in Night Shift.
As a matter of fact, I did. I played the Fonz and I wanted to.
Oh, I had your poster in my room. Don't worry.
I think you show great taste.
But that role in Night Shift, when I saw that comedy side of you, that's what this role reminds me of.
Well, Ron Howard said, look, you can play either role in Night Shift, just be in the movie.
Yeah.
I had been talking to Ron since the first year of Happy Days that he wanted to be a director, and I just knew he would be great.
And now, an author.
And now an author.
On top of it, Alien Superstar.
Yes, with an incredible partner named Lynn Oliver, who runs the Society of Children's Book Writers and Illustrators. And this is our 35th novel together.
You're kidding.
Wow. Yeah. And it's a brand new character. An alien is 13 years old. At 13, the squadron on his planet turns off all ability to enjoy taste, sound, smell, culture, art. His Grandma Wrinkle, says, not you. And she is the mechanic for the Starfleet.
Yeah. Mm.
She cobbles together a spaceship. He takes off just in time. As the moon is in the right place, he flies all the way to Earth and lands on the one address they know on Earth, the back lot of Universal Studios. Who was going to question?
What's the age range here?
Fourth
to eighth.
It's a comedy, but it is about body shaming, about authenticity, bullying, and what happens if you reveal your real self? Will you still be accepted?
Yeah.
Mm. I want to go listen to you read this book.
I read it on tape. Now, you know what? That is the most difficult thing I've ever done in my career, because I'm so dyslexic. Reading off the page, whether I wrote it or not, it most people do a book in a day and a half.
Yeah.
I did it in 3.5.
Wow. Oh,
just real quick, because we only have just a minute left, but tell me about this picture at Wrigley Field.
Oh,
you and the cast of Happy Days, 1979.
Oh, we don't have it. Are you sure we have that?
You know what? We came
here. Oh, my God.
Gary Marshall always wanted to own a sports team. He didn't, so he created one, which was the Happy Days. And everybody on Happy Days but me was a sports fan. And everybody who showed up at Wrigley Field on that day is coming tonight to Anderson's Bookshop in Naperville.
Yeah.
Cool. And it's at the Community Christian Church.
Naperville Christian Church.
That's Phil Donahue. That's Phil Donahue. That was a Chicago.
Donahue, great
interview. Chicago Media All-Star Day.
Yeah. I just saw him. As a matter of fact, I just saw him at the Tony's Award in New York with Marlo.
Yes. Well, it's so great to see you. Thanks for coming in, Henry.
Thank you.
Again, Henry's at the Naperville Community Christian Church tonight at 7 o'clock for a presentation and a book signing. Alien Superstar is the new book. Go to aliensuperstarandersons.brownpapertickets.com for more information.
And we don't leave until everybody's book is signed.
Nicest guy in show business.
Because that's what the nicest guy in show business will do that.
Nicest guy in show business.
He's the best. Yeah.
Thanks, Henry.
Thanks, Henry.
A pleasure to be here. Thank you.
Isn't that nice? He's just so nice.
We could all take a lesson from that.